Airtable just released a new feature that might fly under the radar for some, but it's actually pretty impressive and it unlocks new things and means that we no longer have to do an annoying workaround. We are now able to create an output from our formula that is a single select field. If you're not sure what this means or if you want to dive into it to explore all the new options, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools, and Airtable's one of our favorites. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to join me for automation training. At Gap Consulting, we put together a training for anybody learning to master the fundamental pieces of Airtable. We call it an Airtable crash course. You can sign up at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and I'll include links wherever you found the video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen here, and I'm going to show you how we can now use a formula to output a single select value, and more importantly, I'm going to show you why this matters. So here I am inside of a very simple database. I've got these invoices with a few different, invoice IDs, 1001 to 1003. I've got a formula, and this is what we're going to come back to in just a moment, that's calculating the status of the invoice based on a few different variables. So let's think about what an invoice is. We send it on a certain day. We have certain terms, so a certain number of days that we would expect to get paid. If we do get paid in that time frame, everything's great. If we don't get paid, then of course we are overdue, or the client is overdue. And if we haven't received payment, but we're still within the expected window, then there's no cause for alarm. So we kind of have three different outputs here. You could, of course, envision more depending on how you categorize your invoices. But for our example, I'm just looking at these three. It's either overdue, meaning it should have been paid. It is paid. So cool, we don't care necessarily when it was paid. Or lastly, it's unpaid, but no cause for alarm. So let's take a look at how we might build the logic for this. First and foremost, we can calculate the date due. So we have the date that it was sent, and we have the terms or the number of days for the invoice to become due, so we can calculate when it is due. We do this with a date add formula, as you see here, and here are the outputs. So if we sent an invoice on May 6th and it was under 30-day terms, it will be due on the 5th of July. Similarly, if we sent one on May 1st with 45-day terms, it'll be due on June 15th, and so on. So now what we can do is look at our date paid field, and if we mark that an invoice is paid, it's paid. If it's not marked as paid, then we have to compare it and say, is it overdue or is it not? And so here's what our invoice can look like for that. This is a nested if statement. We've broken this down on previous videos, so if you're curious about how to write a formula like this, you can go ahead and check out those videos. But here we are, we're saying if the date paid exists, then the status output here is paid. Now, if that's not the case, then we're going to evaluate the next condition, which says if the date due is less than or before today, then it's overdue. So for example, today as of filming is June 6th. If I have a due date that is June 4th, then it's less than June 6th, and therefore this thing is overdue. Now, if that's not the case, then our last condition says, well, in the case where it's not paid or overdue, then it's just unpaid, which basically means we're still waiting to get payment and we are within the allotted window of expectation here. So those are our three outputs. Now, we've been able to write this formula forever, but here is where we can now turn this into a single select output, and this is the magic. We go into formatting and we now have a toggle that says, hey, we can actually format this output as single select. If we make that selection, we have to come in and manually name all the different outputs that we might want. So in our example, we've got overdue, paid, and unpaid. And then I've also created an additional one for a default. So just in case something's awry, if our formula is not working and doesn't find one of these three outputs, then we're gonna say, this is the output you should have, which is something alarming like error. Now using this, we can come down to our predefined option here of error. And this is saying, if our output, our formulaic output, doesn't match one of the outputs that we expect it to, then we're going to have this error output. We can also change the color of these so we can say overdue might be alarming, paid is green, and unpaid is well within expectation, so it's blue. Save up these changes. This all impacts us on the formatting, but here's why it matters. Let's flip now into an interface and take a look at what we can do now that we have a single select field as the output. Here inside of our interface, we can add things like filters. If we select this group inside of our dashboard interface, I can apply a filter here to my elements. Let's do a dropdown, for example, and I can include that invoice status. And now inside of our interface, we see the different options that we have in our dropdown. Additionally, you can see that in my graph here, these are being represented as color-coded based on the status. And this is all driven by the color of that single select field that is a formula field. We can also, of course, filter our data and say, I want to look at all my paid invoices and get a vision of that. So now we are able to filter that down with just a simple click. Or look at overdue. Here it is. So this is obviously pretty valuable, but how is it different as if we had not used a single select field? Well, go back into Airtable and let's look at it the old way without turning this into a single select field. Let's toggle off that option and we're just going to have the textual output, not a single select, just text. When I go into my interfaces now, you'll see that I don't have the availability of having that dropdown. That invoice status here, I can't use it. You'll see it's been removed from this. So if we delete this option, delete this entirely, and we go to dropdown again, and we try to add this, I'm not seeing that option. And the reason for that is it's text. We cannot use a dropdown with text inside of our Airtable interface filters. And for good reason. We don't have a limited number of options. A text field could be anything. And so it's impossible to have a dropdown with infinite possibilities. Whereas if we have a single select field, we have a predefined set of options. So the workaround for this used to be that we would have to, in Airtable, take this formulaic output and write an automation that copied this literal text output and then copied it into a single select field. We had an automation that said, anytime you see an update in this formula output, then I want you to perform an automated process where we copy and paste this into a single select field. So it would look a little bit like this, but now we have completely eradicated that. Whereas before we had to have a copy and paste automation that would come in, and anytime a change happened here, update a single select field, and then we could filter based on that. So this is a small new feature, but it has some pretty cool downstream impacts for Airtable users, allowing us now to simplify our workflows, eradicate the need for this dual single select field that's just doing a copy paste redundant automation, and let's instead start formatting this as we intended in the first place, formatting it into a single select field with proper color coding. I know we went pretty fast in this video to explain this cool new feature, so any questions you have, be sure to drop them below. But most importantly, in the meantime, keep on building.